interesting the way they unload the drawings in port. They are breaking it in segments and pushing them through. They're grabbing that segment, turn it around, tip everything out, turn it back, push it forward, next segment, and so on so. Yeah, it's not the...
Copy, in good line.
Just a wagon tipping or not. They grab the whole segment of four or five carriages at a time, and they just turn them upside down, and all the iron ore is falling off. So, yeah, quite a quick way to do it. Last week I done a first trip, so yeah, everything went right, and I found out that at 70 kilometers per hour the off-road mod is disappearing, it's not active anymore. So I'll have to sit under 70 and try to see what's gonna happen today, how it will perform. Thank you. sitting nicely around 1200 reps. It's only going on the second last gear. It doesn't go in the top gear on the 12th. Plenty of power. So what this off-road mode is doing, controlling traction and power of the engine. It doesn't have anything to do with suspensions or stuff like that. No, basically it's just controlling your traction, power, and it's working automatic diff locks were needed, and all this. was asked by one of the viewers if on a dirt road there are speed limits. Yes, they are. Like on this one, maximum speed limit is 80 kilometers an hour. Are we obeying them? Yes, we do. Because once you go over 80 on this road, it's not safe anymore. You can lose traction very easy. You can start drifting all of a sudden. You end up with the wheels in the top. In other words, ass overhead. Doesn't take long. These kind of roads are the easiest ones to have a rollover, because it's so easy to lose control. Then you hit a pothole or a rock or something. Well, your steering wheel will be smashed in pieces. Your steering tires will be damaged. Steering box, the whole steering system will be gone. So it's not worth it to take a risk like that. And then of course there are sections of the road, even that it says you can go 80 or 60 or whatever. You can't do even half of the speed because of the big corrugation. Section of the road here when I was last with the K200, how rough it was. One of the viewers even put a comment, lucky you don't have a denture. That bad. Everything was shaking in a cabin up this ramp here. Now I can't even feel a thing. But that doesn't mean that the truck is not. It's taking all the heart beating, but it's not transmitting any of that inside of the cabin. Or in the steering wheel, I don't feel anything. To my hands. this underpass here, it's quite a dangerous one because it's narrow, it's in a bend, you don't see what is coming from the other side. Look at all these hard workers. Not a worry in the world. We'll have a meeting how to do it. Then the meeting will continue with questions and answers, and then will be all the debating, what if, what that, and by the time they will be ready to start doing something, it's 4 o'clock, let's go back to the camp. Not a bad life, eh? this road. Won't take long before I will learn how to fly. Not so much how to land, but yeah. Where it's a lot of sand, you can see a lot of sand on it, are the worst ones, because you don't know what that sand is hiding under. How big the corrugations are under or anything. That's it, that sand, and yeah, sometimes I do feel how the tri lights moving left and right when I pass sections like this. In a truck, you actually put your life in the hands of a machine. So handle that machine with care. Don't try to be Superman. As a child,
oh, yeah, we get turned with a dolly over there, yeah.
As a bloody radio. As a child, I learned a lot about drugs from my father. He was a truck driver all his life. He's been driving for 37 years until he retired. And tell you that much, that time was not that much about protection, safety and all this, but he always was pointing to towards this. Be careful what you do behind the wheel. You put your life in the hands of machine, handle with care. He was pointing this all the time. 37 years, he never had an accident. And he's been driving all sorts. That is what I learned to drive on a construction site with him. I was still in a school, and in school holidays, and sometime even after school, I was just itching to go with him for a ride and get a bit of feeling behind the wheel and all this. Yeah, the first ever vehicle that I drove was a 5 cubic meters concrete agitator. It's a rigid truck. Then he teach me how to drive a tipper, which wasn't my real cup of tea. I don't like them. They are not called tippers for nothing, because if you are not careful, you can tip the whole thing in a matter of seconds, not just the product, the whole thing. When he was getting a bit more old, then he started driving buses, taking the workers on the sites and coming back empty. It was my happy time, having an empty bus. He was allowing me to jump behind the steering wheel. So yes, trucking, it's in the blood. Even that he was fighting so hard to keep me away from trucks. So I done the college and I become an electrician. But as soon as I migrated to Australia and I was on my own, out of his control, I just chucked it away and started to driving trucks. So yeah, this is how all started. Now back to our business. As you can see, well, what can I say? The road is very rough today. That grader never been through for more than a week now. But inside of the cabin, I'm not feeling much of it. Yeah, I can hear outside all the rattling and all that, but not inside, so it's handled very well, this kind of roads. Even that it's not that solid like a Kenworth, and I know it's not gonna last that long. Sooner or later this will take a toll on it, but till then, doing a good job. the road it's the cat. So we're almost there. Double line where they can drive past each other.
Authorised to have you 41G on the front plate.
Copy 41G. Northbound train into the Tenor River Roadworks.
Sorry mate, what was that?
I think he just let us know he was coming through. Cheers mate. So you can push that magic button.
Big can of worms. All that small cars are not gonna be patient. They'll be overtaking left and right. From one end to the other, looks like a good 5 kilometers, if not longer. Maybe longer than 5. moment of truth. How many trailers are left in here? Heaps. Heaps of them. Okay, so this is what I will be taking. This big ugly one and the trailer next to, both of them loaded. This will go at the front since it's the heaviest one. And trailer at the back. Let's do it. Already got the dolly hooked up behind me, so I don't muck around too much. Just get the dolly under the dry pen and then hook up the flat top in a front and we are on our way. This is my little load. It's quite windy, so I'm not going to take the third one as empty behind me, since it's not urgent. I only take the necessary, the two loaded ones, and leave the empty one for someone else to take it. As long as I'm having the two loaded ones, everything could be all right. Okay, so see you down the road. So back on the road. Chose a heavy duty mode since I got this big load. That engine himself, it's about close to 15 ton plus the rest. And let's not forget that I got the dry pan at the back, which is like a sail catching all the wind. But unfortunately, there was no way to have it at the front. It's not heavy enough. Well, guys, this weather, it's a bit with a mind of her own. You live there and it's freezing. You get here and today was boiling. Now, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and it's still, 35 degrees. This happened before. If it's road work, stop.
Yep.
And then there are small cars involved. They have no patience at all. continue to. You can't play with games with trains. They are a lot bigger and longer than me, so have to let them pass first. definitely. I got a big bull bar, but he's not strong enough to stop a cow. Some of these pods that I know, they got actually heavy duty steel bull bar, different story. But I got heavy duty, but it's aluminium, and yeah, it's no match for the cow. When you hit 500-700 kilo animal, it's not ending up good. Okay, finally Cappy, fill up, have a quick shower and go again. Settle down into Cappy. Down out of Cappy. I left Capricornia and I should have enough hours left to make it to Plotonic. Won't be enough to get to the Grusa, but yeah, just to Plotonic gold mine lie down area there, which is about 80-90 kilometers out of Kumarina. I got 2.5 hours of driving left, so it's taking me 1.5 hours to Kumarina. From Kumarina to the Grusa, it's another 1 hour and 10 minutes, so I'm about 10 minutes short. We'll see how I go. If I will have enough, I'll go there. If not, I'll just stop at Plutonic. So at least tomorrow, then from Plutonic to Perth, it's only going to be around 10 hours. So leaving 8 a.m. I should be in Perth in a depot before 7 p.m. Change trailers and be back to Uban before midnight, when I'll be running out of time again. And what a pleasant surprise. I stopped in Capricornia and I saw a guy coming quickly towards me and calling me on by name. And look, do I know him? No, I don't know him. When he came close and he introduced himself, and he told me that he's actually one of my followers on YouTube. Yeah, that was a pleasant surprise. We had a bit of chat. Then I remembered him because he actually put a comment on one of the videos that he's working in a mine site, and he's thinking to leave mine site and get back on a road. And I'm glad that everything worked perfect for him. I was, from what he's saying, a good inspiration. And yeah, that was quite nice. So he made my day. Anyway, guys, we'll see what else happened from here to Plutonic. Let's hope that everything goes alright, no any obstructions on the road or anything. So if nothing goes wrong and everything is okay, we see you down there. Alright, so I'm gonna stop here at Plutonic. To get to the Grusa, I'll be going about 5 minutes over the allowing driving hours, and I don't like that. So I'll be stopping in here for the night. Just looking for a bit of a nice and clean area to stop. Because I can see that too many people left their memories around, so yep, this will do. Alright, so quarter past 11, I'm hungry, I'll have something to eat and then try to go to bed. So good night, guys, and I'll see you in the morning.